of the first Trump administration, you were thrown in jail for executive privilege, a legally protected thing. How bad do you want to see Trump burn this one down?
Yeah, and Carl, I appreciate all your support while I was behind that weaponized prison walls. And you're absolutely on fire today. Look, I think of all the things you said, the one thing I want to focus on, because it's going to happen in less than 24 hours, Senate Republicans are going to pick a new majority leader. And as Carl E. Higbee said, the Senate Republicans were not elected to stop Donald Trump. They are there to implement his landslide, okay? So tomorrow, they're gonna go behind closed doors. I have demanded that they open up the vote instead. They're gonna choose a new leader. The two rhino, never Trumpers, open borders, amnesty, anti-tariff clowns, John Cornyn and John Thune.
Clowns.
Are two of the candidates. You got Florida's Rick Scott, and Carl Higbee just threw a dark horse in the middle of this, J.D. Vance. Clearly, Scott, Vance, somebody who's going to support the president, yeah, needs to be the Senate Majority Leader. If Thune or Cornyn get in, Carl, why this is so important is you're going to see a very different cabinet than you would see with those guys.
Oh, Peter Navarro.
Donald Trump.
Welcome back.
His landslide agenda. Now, the way this works, Carl, we not only have to have a Senate Majority Leader that supports the Trump agenda, he has to promise that 30 days after Trump takes office, the Senate will declare what's called a recess for 30 days. In the recess, Trump will be allowed to appoint all the Senate confirmed members to his cabinet. He can do cabinet secretaries, deputy secretaries. He can do all the alphabet intelligence agencies. He can do the UN ambassador in those 30 days. And if that happens, you'll probably see the Department of Education close the next day.